So what we're trying to do here is trying to develop a system that can do brain imaging off of AA batteries, basically. A very lightweight, portable brain imaging so that we can take brain imaging out of the neuroimaging center and put it into places like space or like the front lines in military settings or so forth. So here we have our model is wearing our device. It's inside the cap. Take the cap off. The sensors are inside. We have an accelerometer in there. We have the sensor itself. That can go on easily.
So this is good. The entire size of an MRI boiled down into...
This is to get similar measurements to MRI. And so we're getting blood volume and blood oxygenation measures, just like you would with a functional MRI scan. The device itself that collects all the data is right here. And we have a series of them that are progressively more complicated that allows us to collect more auxiliary information, more optical information, and that's as compared to the big devices that I have down here that are the full-size laboratory devices. That one's an imager at 150 pounds and is not something you're going to strap to your back and walk around with, whereas this one is designed to achieve that goal.
So talk about, first of all, what are the benefits of this kind of to the astronauts and what we know about flying in space for a long period of time, and also what are the benefits here on Earth? I mean, obviously you're getting smaller fans.
Sure. You know. Yeah, smaller is always good, and lighter and less power requirements and so forth are always good, but for space flight, they're concerned about intracranial pressure alterations, and there have been a series of astronauts that have been diagnosed with elevated pressures, and this provides a way to monitor brain health in space, which is clearly an important aspect of that. We would do it with MRI or CT down here on Earth, but we can't take those up there. So instead, we can take something like this up to do that sort of monitoring. On Earth, this gives us an ability to move more towards the front lines, shall we say. So first responders in the military, in sporting events, we can do home monitoring, such as sleep apnea or syncope, dizziness, feel like you're going to faint. And also is relevant to monitoring people who are very active, like children, autism, or epilepsy. And so being able to take this with you as you go is a novel technology that we just haven't had the ability to try these sorts of things before. So we're excited to get to that point where we can actually use it for these novel applications.
So has this flown yet on board?
This has not flown yet. No, we're developing a series of prototypes to the point and validating it for the various applications that NASA's particularly interested in, like the intracranial pressure.
Talk a bit about, you know, what is it like to actually work on something like this that you know is going to fly on board the station, and how important is the station to this?
It's very exciting to work on it, to be honest. You know, a lot of groups that I have worked with in the past, and it's most fun working with NASA, just thinking about this, contributing to the space program in any sort of way. The right now they have essentially no real way of monitoring brain function in spaceflight, and this is sort of one of the few that has potential in the area, and so we're excited about that. And the goal is to develop it for NASA, but we see a number of clear spin-offs on Earth here that we're eager to pursue as well.